Hi there, Lanners. Gomez here, and today we're going to be using the Druid, or Token Druid deck, or Aggro Druid, however you prefer to say it. Basic concept of this deck is have a lot of like small minions and everything like that, and then buff the hell out of them with like spells like this. And this is good because it's got like a beast synergy. If you have a beast, there's quite a few beasts in this deck, so it lets you draw another card and things like that. You've got a couple of murlocs in this deck so that like they can be activated by Finger, so that like basically he can smash somebody. One of these and one of these comes out, like they've got a lot of damage there, or just two of these just buffing Finger, or just two of these charge. Lot of damage. The basic concept is get a lot of them, buff them, and then get a Savage Roar involved, which just gives all of them plus two attack and then just a lot of damage going forward. You've got like things in here like this that can help make taunts so that you're not getting smashed in the face. This guy's in here just because there's quite a few Paladin decks and that who are playing Murlocs, so it gets rid of that. And he's in here because there's quite a few pirates out there, with Pirate Warrior still being a thing, and Rogues using pirates, so it just deals with the situation there. If your board gets wiped and you've got a lovely spell like this, it just turns all your mana crystals into minions that can then be buffed and then hopefully get a Savage Roar for attack. And the only real like attack spell in here is Swipe. Can be useful to just deal with a lot of things which have like one health and anything like that that are on the board. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Let's go for it. Okay, so we're against the Hunter, so they might have things like they're gonna have a lot of beasts and shit coming out. That's actually an okay starting hand. I mean, it's got beast synergy and things like that. Yeah, go for it. It's got some buff and beast synergy, so yeah, I like that. Oh, Quest! I was not expecting Quest Hunter. I don't see a lot of them about, because basically they just end up using up all their hands. Yep, just gonna put that out straight away, 2x2. Plus it's gonna get buffed next turn, so. I mean, he hasn't got a lot that he can really do to get rid of a 4x4. I mean, he's got Kill Command, but he needs a beast to activate it, and I don't really mind if he wastes one of his Kill Commands on just killing the first minion I've put down. Yep, so buff that. We've got good little stuff going on as well, because I've got obviously got like the main buff, and activating that pirate means that Patches is going to come flying out of my deck as well, so that's okay. Yep, Kill Command, thought you would, but I don't really mind it because it's getting rid of that, and it still means he's only got a 1x1 because he didn't do the trade first of all. Because if he did the trade, he would have a 3x2, which would have been better for him. But yeah, let's just get a lot of things out and then buff the crap out of them. But I mean, I could get No, we'll wait, and then we'll get pirates out and get a murloc out as well and buff everything. So if he was a smart man, he would trade his wolf with one of these guys, because then it turns it into a 3x2. He is, yeah. He's got a lot of minions on deck now, but he hasn't got a lot of cards in his hand. See, that's the problem with the quest, is that now he's like used up near enough all of his cards. He's going to end up top decking soon, and that's going to be fine. I'm okay with that. Let's just buff the crap out of all of these. I mean, I could go for trading, or I could just smash his face. I'm going to go for smashing his face, because I'm going to focus. This is a lot of damage on deck, and he has to deal with it, so I'm going to force him to trade himself. Because then that means, basically, never do a trade if you can force your opponent to do a trade. Because, you know, why would you bother wasting your turn when you can waste their turn? That's what I mean, like, he hasn't got a lot of cards in his hand now. Yeah, because, I mean, he did what he could, but he couldn't clear the board now. Oh, I mean, I could play Finger. No, we'll leave it. Just smash. I mean, yeah, again, I could. Nah, just throw him into it. It's fine. I mean, I know that I've got Finger, who can obviously activate some other murlocs, but nah, it's fine. Nah, I'm just gonna kill, because it would take both of them to take him out. So, with the health that he's got and everything like that, it's better just to force him to do the trade. He's only done 3 of the 7, and look how many cards he's got in his hand. He's not gonna be able to activate his quest in time before I kill him. Hyena's actually a really good card nowadays. But it's not enough for him right now. Let's just get the board for the 2/2s. There's not a lot you can really do about this because they don't have mass. I mean, if he had a what's that secret? I'll think of it in a minute. Exploding trap. If he had an exploding trap, then that's different. But obviously he doesn't, and now he's forcing trade. Even getting a kill command on one of them, wasting that 5 damage. Yep. I mean, he's got no cards in his hand. We got buff as well. I mean, I think he's pretty much fucked, right? He's pretty much dumb, right? Because, yeah, let's just put Finch out just because we can. I mean, I could do the trade. I just... Nah, that's going to go for face. There's not a lot he can really do here. He's lost. It's not good enough. So he can kill one of those guys, but even then, yeah, he's dead. He knows, yeah. Okay, gets another hunter. I don't think it's going to be Quest Hunter, because as I said, don't really see them around too much. So, that's a good start in hand with Beasts. And Beast Synergy as well has turned up, so that is very nice. Savage Aurora is more my like end tactic. I would have got rid of that if I had the chance, but having it there in my hand at least means that I know that I've got my end tactic in hand. It's okay. But this one's probably going to be a more mid-ranged hunter. Let's just play around some shit. They can be tricky depending on what they get. He didn't have a one drop though, because most hunters have one drops. Just going to coin out this other one just to the full maximum damage. Just going full aggro on this. Some might say that was an unwise move, but just coin them both out. 4 damage. And he still doesn't have an answer for that damage. We're going to buff one of them as well. I mean, this is a great start. Just 6 damage instantly going to face. Yep, that's fine. We've got more we've pirate and we got crab. Then if we could savage roar the turn after, then we just do a lot of damage. I mean, part of me wants to do that trade because that could be an annoyance, but it's only got 2 damage, and considering the fact how much damage we're just doing to his face, there's not a real lot that he can do to stop us now. Savage Roar getting involved with them. Ah, that's complicated matters. Really was not. I should have known that was in his deck, because that is an annoyance. I should have dealt with that when I could. Oh well, fuck it. It's all good. Let's just increase these guys with the Taunt Warrior. Go into him, and then yet again, because it's forcing him to do that trade. It's a Taunt Warrior, so he would have to do the trade. So I might as well just go to face. Yeah, again, it's all about that Savage Aurora. I know that I've got it in my deck and it can do a lot of damage. It's okay. Patches lives. That's the main thing. Patches lives. Oh, I've got a buff as well. Just get everything out. I'm not going to go for the buff yet. I mean, technically, I should have gone for the buff, really, because there's a few spells that he could have that could kill them. But that's fine. He wanted the boar. Both times he wanted the boar. And both times he's got the one that he didn't want. But he has put taunt on it again. That's an annoyance. He keeps taunting that minion. I mean, with the buff, that makes that into a 4x2. So that actually makes it can kill that. I think we just flood the board. Turn, what you call it, like a... Do the 1x1. He can go into which Turtle Man can go into him and kill the taunt. I mean that seems legit to me. That's got Divine Shield as well. Yeah. I mean, plus those 2 raptors that got from his death rattle. I mean, Savage Roar on everything. There's not a lot he can really do. He has to wipe my board. And as I said, exploding trap would knock out quite a few things. But I was using the kill command. If he plays a secret now, no, he hasn't got a secret. Okay, so he hasn't got exploding trap. Explosion trap would have been an annoyance and would have stopped the plan, but... Yeah, well, actually, no, it wouldn't have stopped the plan, because Savage Roar, that's got Divine Shield, so it wouldn't have been affected. Oh, well, let's just kill him. Savage Roar, just too good. There we go. Well, I tried to do something different this time, but actually showing you, like, full-on matches, what I'm doing the whole time. Let me know what you thought, if you prefer that, or you prefer, like, the little cuts of certain segments of things like that. Either way, I just thought it'd be interesting to see, like, what I'm thinking for a match. Let me know in the comment section down below. But if you liked this video, hit that like button, comment down below on what you thought, as I said. And if you're not already subscribed, then why not hit that subscribe button, because there's content coming out every week. And if you like this video, you'll probably like all the other videos we make. Until next time, guys. Bye.
Bloody time warp. You need at least another two of them.
Because then they can just, like, continuously just throw fireballs at you if they've got, I can't remember the name of the legendary now. Guy who, whenever you cast a spell, get... Oh, that's the guy.